DERC, Sanctions to Opportunity to Present at Bioinformatics Community Conference, the Pipeline, HRI-GWAS. HRI-GWAS is a portable Genome One Association study workflow for Africa Science, developed inside HRI-BioNet Network. I'm Jean-Tristan Vandenbroek, and currently working in Sene Brenner Institute in Wits University, South Africa. My project based on the study of kidney disease in Africa and GWAS. Objective of Genome One Association study is to find genome position, origins, inference, phenotypes using HiCap-free genomic with statistical association. GWAS requires several complex and numerous steps. The first step is to sample individuals and have the phenotypes and DNA. You need to genotyping the DNA, for instance, with DNA chip or whole genome sequencing. Also followed by quality control of phenotype or genotype. In the case of the DNA chip, you need to input your genotype data. The association can be done with the various software as Splink, Gemma, or BoltLMN. To better define your position of interest, you can do post-association analysis with fan mapping or annotation for instance. All steps use various formats and different software. HRI-BioNet supports the Human Health and Heredity in Africa Consortium. This objective of this network is to build capacity in bioinformatics in Africa with building data and software infrastructure. More than 30 nodes across Africa with US partners. One of these objectives is to build pipeline, portable, scalable, and flexible to support HRI Africa Science. HRI-GWAS is one of these pipelines. It supports different phases of GWAS. For instance, the calling data of Illumina, the QC pipeline of genetics data. For the association genomics, we propose different approaches and software. Also, different steps of post-association analysis is possible as heritability, annotation, simulation. Also, the pipeline proposes a lot of scripts to format files. The amputation step is developed on the chip amputation pipeline inside the HRI-BioNet network. To build the HRI-GWAS workflow, we decide to use Nextflow as workflow. We can use the pipeline in different environments, single computers, Slurm, PBS, or Amazon Batch. You can use container as Docker and Singularity. We decide for each task or step to use independent script. You can find the pipeline in GitHub repository. At end of each task, you can have a report for user. One of these tasks is the association between genetics and phenotypes that I will present you. It uses an input, Splink format, phenotype file, phenotype, and covariate, with possibility to run several phenotypes. The first step of this pipeline will transform and format data for each software. It will run in parallel different software of association, and for each run, do Manhattan plot, QQ plot, and extract best result. At the end, it will give you a report in PDF with all this information. To conclude, HRI-GWAS pipeline provides a portable and robust pipeline for reproducible genome-wide association study. Reproducibility, we can run the entire analysis from start to end. Reusability, you can run the entire analysis with different parameters. Portability, we can run the analysis on a laptop, on a server, on a cluster, in the cloud. HRI-GWAS and associated pipeline give you tools on the majority step of GWAS. Each step can be used independently. HRI-GWAS is under development to respond to researchers and users. Of course, HRI-GWAS, because it's in development, need improvement, for instance, for the test dataset. So I will wait, thank you on all the co-authors that help a lot to develop this pipeline, and thank a lot to all the users and partner for testing. Thank you for your attention.